Some things science can't explain. Tide goes in, tide goes out. You can't explain that. I'm kidding, we can totally explain that. What's up, our semi-diurnal viewers? Julian here for DNews. Over the weekend, the coast of Britain was hit with big waves and some of the highest tides in 20 years. What's causing these huge tides? And why do we even have tides at all, for that matter? Well, most people are taught that the moon controls the tides, and that's pretty much where their education ends. While that's most of what you need to know, it may be a bit confusing when you look closely. It's logical that water would be drawn towards the moon because of its gravitational pull, causing a tidal bulge in that direction. Weirdly, though, a tidal bulge also forms on the opposite side of the planet, and there's no secret moon over there. So what's going on? Well, you have to remember that the moon's gravity isn't just pulling on water, it's pulling on the whole Earth, too. Water closest to the moon gets drawn toward it hardest, the Earth gets tugged toward the moon a little less vigorously, and the water on the far side of the Earth is pulled much less, so essentially it's being left behind and forming its own little lump. Our moon has a slightly elliptical orbit that varies how far away it is by about 50,000 kilometers each month. When it's closest, or perigee, tides are more pronounced than when it's farthest at apogee. Another factor affecting the tides is land. If the Earth had no Earth, then the tidal bulges would stay in line with the moon while the planet and its water spinned under them. But luckily for things with legs, we do have land. The continents keep the water from flowing freely, and it complicates tidal patterns. Most places get two alternating high and low tides a day. If the highs and lows are about the same, it's called semi-diurnal. If they're different, it's a mixed semi-diurnal pattern, and if they get one high and one low tide a day, it's diurnal. The moon is the biggest factor at work, but the sun's getting in on the action too, with solar tides being about half as big as lunar tides. When the sun and the moon are aligned twice a month, we experience extreme highs and lows called spring tides because their powers combine. When the sun and the moon are at right angles, their gravities smooth out the bulges, and the less extreme differences are called neap tides. Over the weekend, Britain was on the wrong side of all of these factors. The moon was in perigee, in line with the sun. Bad luck, but it was bound to happen eventually. At least there's no vengeful Anglophobic curse at work that we can't explain. While it's true there are plenty of things science hasn't figured out yet, we've got tides pretty much on lock. So the outside of the planet obviously has a lot going on, but there's plenty of movement and shaking under the surface too. Trace talks about what we figured out in this video.
The new model has revealed the moon-sized inner core is super-rotating in an easterly direction, and the outer core is flowing much slower in a westerly direction.
We've also got a link in the description if you want to check out the full episode. So, what are some other natural phenomena you want us to explain? Let us know in the comments, and I'll see you next time on DNews.